Hello everyone, this is Dr. Fox. Let's talk about the osteology of the orbit. So I'd like to start by using the color-coded skull so that we're not limited or encumbered by weak or missing sutures between these bones so that we can all see their margins in a way that is unambiguous as possible. So let's start with the orbital rim. The orbital rim is a circle which goes about the anterior margin of the orbit. It's formed of three bones, the frontal, the zygomatic, and the maxilla. As we go deeper into the orbit, we see that there are other bones which comprise this, namely the lacrimal. It's probably not best in this particular view, but the ethmoid and the sphenoid. We also know that there is a teeny, teeny, tiny part of the palatine bone as well. So let's take a look at these bones in a non-color-coded skull. So we can start with the frontal bone, aptly named because it is the front of the neurocranium. We can see in the superolateral surface of the orbit here, there is a slight indentation. This indentation accommodates the lacrimal gland, and it is thus called the lacrimal fossa. Turning our attention to the contralateral side of the skull, we have a very good view of the sphenoid bone here. The sphenoid bone is going to include the optic canal. That optic canal is going to be a passageway for cranial nerve 2, the optic nerve, as well as the ophthalmic artery. And we also have the superior orbital fissure and the inferior orbital fissure. The superior orbital fissure is a passageway between the orbit and the middle cranial fossa. So it's a means of conveyance for cranial nerve 3, the oculomotor nerve, cranial nerve 4, the trochlear nerve, V1 and its branches. So that is the ophthalmic nerve or ophthalmic division of the trigeminal nerve, cranial nerve 5. It will also convey the abducens, cranial nerve 6, and it will convey the superior and sometimes branches of the inferior ophthalmic veins back to the cavernous sinus. The inferior orbital fissure is a means of conveyance between the orbit and the pterygopalatine fossa, and this allows for branches of V2, which is the maxillary division of the trigeminal nerve, to traverse the orbit. And then finally, we have the ethmoid bone. The ethmoid bone, I'm just going to follow it. There is a part of the medial wall of the orbit. The features that I look to identify the ethmoid bone are the anterior and posterior ethmoidal foramina, which are going to be between the orbit and the ethmoidal air cells and the nasal cavity deep to that. The ethmoid bone is sitting just posterior to the lacrimal bone, which I'm outlining here, which is sometimes difficult to discern the difference between those two bones. So we've discussed the various bones of the orbit as well as some of their features. Thank you very much for your time.